नमस्कार, हूँ आदर्श छू। वेलकम टू आदर्श एजुकेशन सोसाइटी।
हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल स्टडी द एक्सरसाइज 6.3। दिस इज द एक्सरसाइज ऑफ स्टैंडर्ड 8, चैप्टर नंबर 6, स्क्वायर्स एंड स्क्वायर रूट्स। सो व्हाट इज द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन? द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज What could be the possible ones digit of the square root of each of the following numbers? So here we have given some of the square numbers. And what will happen if we apply the square root to that number? What is the number we get? What will be the ones digit? At the place of ones, what digit we can get? Possible ones digit. That we have to find out. So whatever the number we have given are the perfect square numbers. So here the first number we have given is 9801. So this is a perfect square number. Now remember the property when we study the square numbers, right? When we apply the square of the number 9, then we get the 81. In the same way, when we apply the square of 1, then again we get the 1. So, when we get the 1, whenever we apply the square of 1, either 1 or the 9. At the both numbers, we apply the square, we get the number 1 at the unit place in the square number. So, now here we have to use the reverse process. Here we have given the perfect square number. And we have to say that what will be the possible ones digit. Possible ones digit of the number, here we can say that is either 1 or 9. Right? Because whatever the digit, if we have at the 1 or 9 at the unit place and we apply the square, we get the number 1 in the perfect square number. Understand? Okay. Let us see the another number, that is 99856. So see, here 6 is at the unit place number. So whenever we apply the square of the 4, that is what? 16. We get the 6 at the unit place number. In the same way, when we apply the square of 14, we get the 256. Again 6 is there. So here 6 is at the unit place of the perfect square number. So when we find out the square root of this number, the unit place in the digit may be either 4 or the 6. Okay. So in this way we can write down this unit place digit number. Now based on these two questions you can solve the another questions. Okay. Now let us study the question number 2. What is the question? Question here is, without doing any calculation, find the numbers which are surely not perfect square number. So here we have given the 4 different numbers, right? One number is 153, 257, 408 and 441. So here we do not have to apply any method to find out the square root. Without doing the square root, we have to check whether they are the perfect square or not. So see, if you remember the property of the square number, then it is said that whenever there is a 2, 3, 7 and 8, 2, 3, 7 and 8 at the unit place number, that number could not be the perfect square number. So here in the first number 153, 3 is there, in this number 7 is there and in this number 8 is there. So all these 3 numbers we can say that are not perfect square numbers. If they are not the perfect square number, we cannot find out the square root of these numbers. Okay. So see, here there is a number 441 and 1 is the unit place number. So see, what will happen if the 1 and the unit place number? That means when we find out the square root of this number, whatever the number we get, the unit place number must be 1 or 9. The unit place number we get must be 1, either 1 or 9. So this number can be the perfect square number of any number. That is why we can find out the square root of this number. In these three numbers, it is not possible because they are not the perfect square numbers. Understand? Okay. Let us study the question number 3. Question number 3 is, find the square roots of 100 and 169 by the method of repeated subtraction. See, here we have to apply the method of repeated subtraction. First of all, we will find out the square root of 100. So, you know that how we have to apply this method? 100 minus 1. First odd number 1, that is 100 minus 1, that is 99. Now the second, 99 minus 3, that is the second odd number 3. So here we get 99 minus 3 is 96. Again apply this method. So 96 minus 5, third odd number, that is we get here is 91. Okay, now from this 91, again subtract the next odd number, that is 7. So 91 minus 7, that we get is 84. Now from 84, again subtract the next odd number, that is 9. So 84 minus 9, that is 75. Right? Now from this 75, again subtract the next odd number, that is 11. And 75 minus 11 we get is 64. Now from this 64, again subtract the next odd number, that is 13. And 64 minus 13 we get is 51. Now this 51, again subtract the next odd number, that is 15. So when we subtract this 15, what we get here is 41 minus 5, that is 36. Okay. Now again 36 minus next odd number, that is 17. When we subtract this 17, what we get here is 90. And now from this we have to subtract the next odd number, that is 19 minus 99. We get the 0. So now calculate how many steps we apply here. First, second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh, eighth, ninth, and tenth. At tenth step, we get the subtraction 0. So here we can write down the square root of 100 is what? Is 10. So this is how we can use the repeated subtraction method. Now let us find out the square root of 169. So here 169 minus 1, that is the first odd number. 168 we get. 168 minus 3, here we get the 165. Now 165 minus 5, that is we get 160. Now 160 minus 7, that is we get 153. 153 minus 9, and here we get the 144. Now 144 minus 11, and 144 minus 11 we get is 133. 133 minus 13. 133 minus 13 is 0, 2, 1, 120. 120 minus 50. So here we get 105. Now 105 minus 17. Next odd number. That is 105 minus 17. We get 88. Right? 88 plus 17. That is 105. Now again 88 minus next odd number, that is 19, and 88 minus 19 we get is 69. Right? Now 69 minus 21, that is we get is 48. Now 48 minus next odd number, that is 23, and what we get here is 25. And now next number is 25 minus 25, and that is equals to 0. So here again we get this total subtraction is 0. Now calculate how many steps we apply here. First, second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh, eighth, ninth, 10th, 11th, 12th and 13th. Total 13 step we apply here. So we can say that the square root of 169 is what? 1330. Okay, so this is how we can use the repeated subtraction method to find out the square root. Okay, this is all about this lecture. Thank you.
Thank you for joining us.